Good morning, everybody. I first want to acknowledge that this meeting is being held on the unceded territory of the Stalo people. Yesterday, we evacuated over 1,000 homes in Yarrow and Majuba Hill. Into the evening, the city of Abbotsford warned that their Barrowtown pump could fail. This created a bigger risk of flooding for Yarrow. Fortunately, this area was under an evacuation order. Other areas of Chilliwack are not under the threat of flooding. Barrowtown pump station is currently accessible from the Chilliwack side, which meant that Chilliwack could show up in any situation, which they did. More than 200 Chilliwack residents, operations staff, and Chilliwack firefighters showed up to protect that piece of infrastructure. Together, they built a 25-meter-long sandbag wall to protect. This emergency has shown how important community is. Thank you for all the volunteers that assisted last night. Thank to everybody who has taken in somebody to be evacuated. City staff continue to monitor water levels and the dikes. And I have Director Blaine here with a little short message. Director Blaine.
Good morning. We've received a lot of questions about how the flooding affects Chilliwack. So the flooding in Sumas Prairie is coming from the Nooksack River in Washington State to the south. And this is what's causing concern in the Yarrow area, and that's why people have been evacuated. And I'd like to emphasize there's no risk to the city's dike system, and beyond the Yarrow area, there are no additional concerns about flooding in Chilliwack. One additional issue, we do have some hillside washouts. Staff are coordinating road repairs as quickly as possible. We ask that people respect road closures. It is for their safety and the safety of the work crews. Thank you.
Thank you, Mr. Blaine. And now I'd like to introduce Chris Wilson. He is the emergency coordinator for the city of Chilliwack. Chris?
Good morning. Just like to provide you a quick update on the evacuation, the status of the number of evacuees we serviced yesterday. So yesterday, our emergency support services team registered over 640 evacuees, and 190 of those are in group lodging facilities within the city of Chilliwack. Sorry. 190 people are within group lodging facilities within the city of Chilliwack, that being Evergreen Hall and the Chilliwack Landing Sports Center. We have had overwhelming requests for two items in particular. Donations, people wanting to drop off donations at those sites. Unfortunately, at this time, the city is not accepting any donations, but people are very, very much appreciated for the compassion, and I would suggest that they take to social media, various Facebook groups, to maybe see if there's avenues for donation there. Due to the great community spirit in Chilliwack as well, we've also had several requests for people wanting to volunteer and help out. We have taken several names, and there aren't any openings yet for any more volunteers. We do have enough names at this time to be able to staff any unmet needs, but very thankful for everybody's outpouring of support and offering to help. The evacuation order remains in place for Yarrow and Majuba Hill. Access is restricted to that area, and RCMP are providing continuous patrols to ensure the safety of the public is preserved in that area.
Thank you, Chris. Now I will open it up to questions from the floor. And maybe I get you guys come a little bit closer, because there'll be some technical questions that I probably can't answer. Go ahead, Leanna, the first question.
Okay, first question we have today is from Don Lane at Fraser Valley News.
Mr. Lane, you're muted.
There we we go. Thanks. Last night, Prime Minister Trudeau mentioned you and other mayors in a message on Twitter. As I understand, we're waiting for the Public Safety Minister Farnworth to make an announcement. Are we expecting military to roll in any time, or do we have a timeline?
The expectation is, yes, they will be rolling in. At what point, I'm not sure. I did have a conversation with the Prime Minister last night, and he reiterated that exact fact, that they are sending them in. Anybody want to add anything? Nope. Okay. Next question.
Next question is Grace Kennedy with the Fraser Valley Current.
Good morning, Grace.
Hi, yeah, thanks for taking my question. Were there any people left in Yarrow and Majuba Hill after the second evacuation order last night?
I'll put that over to Chris.
Thank you. By about mid-afternoon yesterday, we had intel that about 90% of the community of Yarrow had been evacuated successfully from the area without incident. We think that everybody that was going to get out did leave, and again, we stress, due to the imminent danger to public life, public safety, and property, that everybody must evacuate the area immediately. But we do have knowledge that most all of the area was evacuated by about mid-afternoon yesterday.
Next question.
Next question is coming to us from Jennifer Feinberg with the Chilliwack Progress.
Hello, Jennifer.
Hello, good afternoon. I'm curious if there's any more concern about the Barrowtown pump station.
I will get Director Blaine to speak into that.
Yes, we have been in contact with City of Abbotsford staff. And as Mayor Popoff mentioned, our crews were helping to place sandbags at the pump station. There is concern that the pumps would stop pumping at some point during today. We don't know if or when. They're obviously doing their very best. And, that's really the basis for the Euro evacuation still being on.
Thank you.
Thank you, David. Next question.
From Francis Beulah at the Globe and Mail.
Good morning, Francis.
Oh, hi. Oh, sorry. I'll come on video. This is a bit of an old question, but I'm asking everyone anyway. Do you feel that having a provincial alert would have helped with anything, stopping people from driving on Highway 1, which ended up with, people getting trapped, or for any kind of evacuation? Or do you feel like local officials are handling it the best on their own?
I'll put that over to Chris.
Thank you. So, of course, mass alerting is a convenient tool with some application. In this instance, we've had excellent coordination with the RCMP and other agencies, and we felt that enough word got out in a timely manner. And again, the evacuation, as stated, went quite smoothly. RCMP were placed at all checkpoints and egress routes out of the area. And again, we had a safe evacuation without incident.
Thank you, Chris. Any further questions? Yep.
We have time for one more. Grace Kennedy, Fraser Valley Current.
Good morning, Grace.
Hi. Thanks again. So you say right now there's no risk to any other areas of Chilliwack for flooding. In the event that the Barrowtown Pump Station does, get overfill and can't pump anymore, is there a risk for the area kind of near there, or how are you guys monitoring that situation?
Okay, David Lane.
Yes, the only area that's connected to that drainage basin is Yarrow, and that's why it's been evacuated. We do have staff in the area closely monitoring water levels, and we are in contact with City of Abbotsford staff, so we'll know if the pump station stops pumping. The best thing we can do is monitor water levels and monitor the Nooksack River levels, and we'll know, what the situation will become should the pumps stop acting.
Okay, thank you.
That's it. Okay, I want to thank everybody that dropped onto this call. With things unfolding quickly, we may do this again with new information in upcoming days. So again, thank you for being on the call. Enjoy the rest of your day. Thank you.